ओम शांति। गाइस कैन यू हियर मी? So let's start the session. Come into the sitting posture. Keep your back, neck straight, aligned. Relax your body and go into your asana. Go into your posture. Gently close your eyes. Take a deep, prolonged, slow inhalation. Deep, prolonged, slow exhalation. Inhale and exhale with awareness from the belly. Now, inhale for the take a deep, prolonged breath for the Shanti, shanti, shanti. Feel the vibration and sensation. Join your both palms. Rub your palms. Place on your eyes. Very slowly while thinking, looking at your palms. Gently open up your eyes. Smile. And say, I'm shy. So in previous session, we discussed about the Sapta Prakriti. We talked about the Vata dominant personality, Pitta dominant personality, and the Kapha dominant personality. Now after that, Vata, Pitta, and Kapha, we have the three other combination personality. Combination personality means like two dosha is dominating in the same time. So like these are three dosha. When two dosha are dominating in the same time, that is the combination personality. Like yesterday, one of you asked about it, that if you have the few traits of the Vata, so it means you have the other traits of the other personality. So it's a combination personality. Three dosha would be dominating in you. And according to the, you know, these characteristics, we're going to figure out which dosha you are. Basically, it's you're gonna figure out by yourself. I'm not gonna tell you. So if even you're not figuring out, that's completely okay. That is not our task. For that, you have to require deeper understanding. And there's other aspect you have to, you know, keep in your mind. And there's a doctors, Ayurvedic doctors, and there are yoga therapists, like professional yoga therapists, and those who can able to figure out behalf of the you. Within a 1 month, it's a little bit difficult to figure out. But I think after that, you have the deeper understanding of like how this combination personality is basically dominating and what are the characteristics. So let's talk about that. I'll share you some pictures. One which give you a little bit idea about it. So could you see these? We talked about Vata, Pitta and Kapha. All of you can see this. Now, fourth one, the fourth personality is a combination personality, Vata and Pitta personality. So here the Vata and Pitta are gonna dominate. So Vat, it means character, half of you are having the characteristic from the Vat and half characteristic from the Pit. So certain traits coming from the Vat and certain would be from the Pit. What happened, Vat and Pit? Basically, for example, maybe you have the Vat personality. It's like your Mula Prakriti is Vat. You born with the Vat personality. So your body frame, like you are thin, okay, you are short heighted, you have the dull skin, your body type is the Vata one. But Pitta can be your mental body. It can, like, you become aggressive, impatient. Vata also become impatient, but now they are more aggressive and aggression, they lose their temperament, they do the planning. Right, whatever characteristic we talked about in the psychological characteristic, that come here. Or it could be vice versa. You would be having the Pitta body, like very handsome, beautiful, sharp-minded, intelligent, you know, very attractive personality you are having, but absent mind. You are absent-minded, forget the things easily. You do the calculation, but you also forget the things. You know, have you seen the people who do the planning, but they write it down everything on the pad and get bored easily, quick temperament, like quick implementation of everything, anxious, insomnia, having the difficulty in the sleep. So it could be the vice versa. So both traits we discuss very much in detail of the Vata and Pitta. Now you can combine here. So you're gonna share Vata and the Pitta here. So the characteristic of the Vata we discussed already in detail, and the characteristic of the Pitta. And then problems, occupation. So these personality are good in doing. They can be an entrepreneur also because they are good in the planning as well. They are guide also. They can work as a guide. They are very social as well. So they can go in the public relationship or external affair, career where you have to, you know, do the courses, PR, public relationship, HR, human resources, marketing. They can do very well in that. So the occupation which required planning as well as socializing, those occupation is good for them. Problems, hypertension, hyperacidity, acid reflux, cardiovascular issues, diabetic, then dry skin, burning in the skin, sensitive skin, dry with sensitive skin, rashes on the skin. These kind of problem is very common for the Vata Pitta personality. So cure, we're going to talk later on how we can prevent it. That's we come to later on. So Vata and Pitta personality, these are the basic problems. Now come to the fifth, Kapha and the Pitta. Kapha and the Pitta personality, Kapha, understand when Kapha come into the combination, it's like good one. It is a good for the personality. So Kapha Pitta personality is like okay personality. It's like better than the Vata Pitta, because Vata and Pitta is a deadly combination. No, Vata is also instable and Pitta is also instable. Pitta is more active physically, Vata is more active mentally. Pitta is, so both, there's a, you know, hyperactive. Vata Pitta give you the hyperactivity, make you hyperactive, very restless person. Not able to sit, very difficult for them to sit and do the practice of meditation, very difficult. And Vata Pitta also, their relationship is not good either. The fourth personality, and very, you know, repulsive. So Vata and Pitta is not considered to be good, because Vata and Pitta both are the dangerous combination. But when Kapha come into the combination with the Vata or Pitta, when Kapha is combined with any other three dosha, it stabilizes basically. It brings a little bit calmness and pause to the activity. Kapha is like pause to the activity for any moment. Give you stability a little bit. So Kapha and Pitta, you can see like, again, good one. Loyal Kapha, we talked about the caring, loyal, passionate, compassionate, empathize with the emotion, very emotional personality, very calm, cool, chill personality, but lazy, lethargic also. So Kapha and Pitta, like people who are maybe having the obesity problem, very heavy, but lose the temperament, very active physically. They're very heavy though, but very active. They can do anything. All kind of activity they can perform. Very fit. Like in India, there is a dancer like Feroz Farah Khan or Saroj Khan. These are the choreographer and very heavy by personality. So, but very active, you know, they are dancer, they have to dance. So very active. Or sumo or wrestler, very heavy. Their diet is also heavy. But very active. They are in the sports. Heavy, but they are in the sports. But it can be vice versa, very handsome, very, you know, beautiful features they are having, but very lazy. Mind would be lazy. Very chill, take the things, take for granted, always postponing the things. That can be also possible. Then problems, what kind of problems you know, face an occupation? The occupation, they are in the sports where activities required. they also good in the text job, doing the research, anything which is required planning and sitting. It can be possible they are, because Kapha is there, so they don't like much movement sometimes. So they can enjoy the sitting jobs as well. But sometimes when Pitta is dominating in them, they become active even. So all kind of occupation which required doing the research, and sometimes they can lose the temperament also. And losing the temperament is not good for doing the any kind of research. If they control that thing, they can be a great scientist. So Kapha Pitta. Now their problems. They can have the upper respiratory and lower respiratory problems. Upper and lower respiratory problems they can have. They can have kidney, gallbladder issues also. Stone related issues they can have. Stone in the kidney, stone in the gallbladder. All kind of fever, flu, hay fever, that can also because imbalance of the Kapha and Pitta. Even the COVID is this COVID situation is basically Kapha. It increases the Kapha, and when we are providing the treatment, also imbalancing the Pitta. So now come to the sixth personality, Vata and Kapha. Vata and Kapha, again half of the traits of the Vata and half of the Kapha. Very lean body structure. But heavy. They can be lazy, lethargic. They can sleep a lot even. They love sleeping. So maybe their body type is Vata and Kapha can be mental body. Or Kapha can be body type and Vata would be the mental body. It can be vice versa. Problems which are associated with the Vata and Kapha, majorly both kind of problems they're going to have it. Asthma, respiratory issues, even diabetic also happen because of Vata and Kapha even imbalance. Then there's an infection, vaginal infection, periods, problems in your menstruation cycle, irregular periods, that also because of the Vata and Kapha. These are the general problems. Yeah, there's a role of the Kapha in thyroid glands. If your thyroid glands, it's not functioning, one of the three dosha is imbalanced, and there's a chance that there would be a kapha imbalance. Vat, Pitt and Kapha now, okay, occupation, any kind of, we already talked about, they are suitable for the Vat profession as well and Kapha profession. They can choose, they are very talkative also, sometimes they are also lazy, they are very socialized but loyal also. So any profession which is that same profession which is did by the Vata dominant personality, same here they can practice, and Kapha profession. So Vata Kapha personality, Vata Pitt and Kapha. Sani Pataj personality, which we write it down. Sani Pataj. Sani Pataj is like imbalance of the all three. Or balance of the all three. So if I'll write it down. Two types. It is imbalance. Imbalance of three. Okay, imbalance of three. That calls Sanipataj. Sometime all three dosha gonna be imbalance. So sometime you feel like there is a Vat, Pit and Kapha symptoms. And then it's very big, difficult to treat. Like when dominance, one dosha go imbalance is easy to treat. Two dosha go imbalance, little bit difficult. When all three dosha go imbalance is most difficult for providing the treatment. And problems, it could be any problem. As I talked about, maybe Vata or Pitta problem you are having, take it as like maybe you have the cold in your body, you are having the headache, like it's talked about the COVID. So COVID entered through your nostril, it start affecting your nostril. So when it's remain in the nostril, it's like again treatable. You can treat it, right? So that's have happened because of the Kapha. Kapha start going imbalance. Okay, then that COVID reaches to your throat, it's affected your throat and giving the problem to your throat area. You feel itching, you know, soreness, inflammation. Inflammation happened because of the Pitt, so Kapha Pitt. Then it reaches to your lungs, last stage. Once it reaches to the last, you know, the lungs, it's become difficult to cure it. Lungs gonna damage. This spread is happening because of the Vata. One place to the other place is affected, other organs is affected because of the Vata. So Vata, Pitta and Kapha, all three dosha is imbalance. So, but once these three dosha come into the balance, that called Vikrit. Remember, Vikrit state, balance of three. Called a Vikrit state. Balance of the three. Remember, so balance of the three, all three dosha are balanced, then you are in the Vikrit state. when they are imbalanced state, sani pataj, it's become very difficult for provide the treatment. But once you by, you know, following the Ayurvedic method or following the Ayurvedic rituals practice, you can bring the balance in these three, and then you can prevent the major principle of the Ayurveda to prevention, to prevent the disease, to keep you healthy. And if you're not healthy, give you, provide you cure and cure for all kind of diseases. From the root level, disease should be removed. That is the major principle of the Ayurveda. So these is the Sapta Prakriti. The Sapta Prakriti, when all three dosha are balanced, formed, this is the seventh types of personality. That Avikrit is the perfect, is the personality of the yogi. You're practicing the yoga, following the path of the yoga, following the, you know, implementing the Ayurveda in your life. You get the balance of the Tridosha, and then you are living healthy life. Health, we already explained according to the Ayurveda. So all three, seventh types of personality is the ideal personality when it's balanced of the three, avikrit state, balance of the three. And it doesn't mean once you reach there, I don't know why, if we're going to talk about it. People, you know, they believe, I don't know why they have the high expectation with the yoga and Ayurveda, that they think that if they are practicing the Ayurveda and yoga for 1 month, the whole life they would be healthy. How it would be possible? Even for small, you know, for example, like you are somewhere you're working as a software engineer or a professor or the teacher in university you are working. You get the job, right? You get the job, you did the hard work, you become IAS officer or the government, in government you are working. You did hard work to reach there. Or CEO of the company. You reach there, right? You get it. Or you are the actor. You get the job. Now, to maintain that position, you are doing what? To maintain that position, you're working hard, no? Daily 8-9 hours, people 12 hours working. Working for what? To maintaining that small designation in their life. So they can be, you know, maintain that position, that designation. Very small, tiny part of their life. But half of the life they spend to maintain that position, the small part. But they believe like for health, 1 month they're going to practice the yoga. 1 month they just practice the Ayurvedic things. And then forever they would be healthy. It cannot, it doesn't make sense. To remain that level, like if you become, if you get your three dosha balance straight, to maintain it, to be there. And if you become yogi, to maintain the yoga, to maintain, to remain the yogi, to be there, to become the yogi after that, still you have to do the work, right? People think once they attain the moksha, once they become the yogi, or once they attain the health, after that, you're not going to practice what? You're going to practice to remain there. The small designation, whatever, which is even not very much important. It's just a small part of your life. But for maintaining that, you're putting so much hard work. But for maintaining the health of your life, you're not giving yourself even 1 hour of your life. So that cannot be possible. Okay, this is very impossible thing. If you're thinking like after 1 month I'll be continuing the Ayurvedic, follow the discipline, and then later on I'm doing the same thing which I used to do, it could not bring the health to you. And if even you get the health, you cannot maintain it. The three dosha, once it balances, you have to maintain. The moment you are not practicing it, again go in balance state. Simple. Even the maybe the few second your three dosha is balanced, then again it's coming to the imbalance state. Like your mind is completely relaxed and calm, your body part organs are relaxed and calm, balance. But the moment you're getting angry, imbalance, reaction, imbalance. So there's a moments even in your life. Sometimes you lose the control, sometimes you are just relaxed and calm. That calmness and relax give the balance to the three dosha. It doesn't mean whole life you remain sick. There's a few time when you are not sick at all. Maybe your three dosha is balanced that time. But the moment you change your climate, the moment you change your lifestyle, the moment you adopt the sedentary lifestyle, your three dosha go imbalanced too. But still, whenever your mind is calm and relaxed, again, your three dosha is coming to the balance state. So we have to prolong that state. That's it. For there, we require the hard work. So to reach, I think, the avikrit people, I think 0.00001%, very few people are. I'm not the three dosha balance person either. I'm working hard on myself even. So very less those who are having the three dosha balanced prolonged time. Even yogi get the imbalance, they also get sick that time, but the duration of the sickness is small. For common people, we increasing the duration of the sickness, but they make short. They also get into the imbalance state, but very quickly they get into the balance state. Getting it? It's just all about what you are prolonging. Your health you are prolonging, or your sickness you are prolonging. So we have to reverse this cycle. We have to prolong our health. You're gonna be sick. Even you become yogi, you're gonna be sick. But you know how your body is functioning. The once you understand this, you know, connection, like how your body is connected with the food, the water, the elements, the Panch Mahabhut, and the universe, you can quickly heal yourself. The procedure of healing becomes fast. So don't expect that much that yoga or Ayurveda do the miracle. It's a science. It's not a miracle which you're gonna see, but it's a complete science. If you're following the method, you will get the benefit. Makes sense? Any doubt till here in this Sapta Prakriti? Today is the Sapta Prakriti. We're gonna finish tomorrow onward. We're gonna talk about the solution now. Now we discuss about the problems. This is how they are forming. Now we're gonna talk about the solution. How we can, you know, bring the balance in the three dosha. How we can prolong our health. Okay, that's how we can. So what kind of method we can implement? So general talk we're gonna have, not specific. I also talked about it. I'll give you all the tricks, all the information from the Ayurveda, which can be implemented on everyone, not specific one. Yes, Ayurveda also talks about individual treatment. Basically, Ayurveda is talking about individual treatment. Okay, but there's a general guidelines as well that we're going to discuss about it. Okay, For that, you don't require the deeper understanding of Ayurveda, and you can just freely, without hurting anybody and hurting yourself, you can just tell that, you can share that information to your students as well. Clear? So any doubt till here in the Sapta Prakriti? Any question? Okay, no question. So good. Let's end the class with the free time om and shanti shanti. Come into the sitting position. Keep your back next week aligned. Gently close your eyes. Go into your asana. Observe your breath. Now, take a deep, prolonged, slow inhalation. Deep, prolonged, slow exhalation. Inhale and exhale deeply. Now, inhale for the three time om along with shanti. Take a deep breath. Join your both palms, rub your palms, place on your eyes, feel the warmth, very slowly while blinking, looking at your palm, gently open up your eyes with a great smile. Bless you guys. Meet you at meditation class.